Hey everybody, it's Kim here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to use a 3D model as a reference in a 2D scene. I've got a scene over here where I've basically got a car that is careening through the scene. So you can see it enters and then turns on its side and kind of turns a corner and then drives off the screen. Right now my car is extremely rough and I actually have a 3D model that I want to use as a reference for this car. But I'm not going to animate the 3D itself, I'm going to use the 3D model as a flattened 2D reference. First I go and I import my 3D model into my library, and then I grab that model and I drag and drop it into my scene. This is where you'll see a dialog box pop up, and you'll get two options. Use the 3D model as a 3D model, or render it to 2D. Now, like I said earlier, we don't want to use the 3D model. We actually want a flattened version of this model that we can then draw from. So we're going to say render to 2D. Then you'll see this screen comes up and you'll be able to see your 3D model in that screen. Down the side here, you have a zoom in and out. And if you hover over the screen and press Ctrl and Shift, you'll be able to rotate your model around. As you're doing that, you'll see that these values down the side here change. So you have a choice. You can either move your model around here in the actual image view, or you can play around here with your rotation, your translation, and your scaling. You can also click Fit Model to View to kind of try and fit the image in the image screen over here. And you also have the option of a focal length. Now 50 is the usual normal average focal length for the human eye, but this is something you can play with if you decide you want to try changing the focal length. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to play around with this until I get it more or less in the angle of the car that I have over here. And when you're happy with the angle that you have, you can then render to scene. And here is our object. Now you can see it still looks kind of 3D, but it is in fact a flattened layer. If you zoom in on this, you'll be able to see you will eventually start losing quality on the image because it is a bitmap layer. Now if we want to move this around, we can grab it with our transform tool. You can shrink it. And you can move it into position. You can even rotate it if you like. So here's my car reference. Now you could leave it like this if you decide you're okay with having the 3D image in here. Or you could do what I'm gonna do with it, which is actually using it as a reference for my drawing. So to do this, I'm gonna create another layer above. This is going to become my neat layer. And I'm going to turn on my light table and then draw over this so that I will have a nice on-model drawing of this car. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to do all three panels and I will see you soon. Okay everybody, I'm back and now you can see I have drawn my Jeep over the bitmap that I have with the 3D on it. And I've done all three panels that I needed to do, using the 3D model as a reference. And you can see that each panel has its own 3D reference layer. So that is how you use 3D as a reference in a 2D scene.